Hello my nail lovelies and welcome to my first nail video. So today's video we are going to be doing a short almond set for my regular client. She wanted me to do a freestyle set. She gave me full permission to take over this set. So she showed me a picture of the dress that she's going to be wearing because she's going to her sister's wedding. So she sent me a picture of the dress, of what color, and it's a green color. So we're going to be doing a French tip green color set today. So I always start off by filing the tips of my pre-shaped nails. This ensures that they are smooth at the tip and so they don't scratch or anything. Also, when you get pre-shaped nails, they have like this little plastic bit at the end of it. So really you're just filing that away. Also, I usually start by cutting them off, but they weren't that bad on these ones. So I just went ahead and filed them, making sure that I'm not filing straight across. I'm following the shape of the nail so that we don't lose the shape of our nails there. But we're still getting them nice and smooth. So I did that on both sets of nails there. Also, I wanted to add, I apologize that of a lot of these clips that I'm not always quite in frame. I was testing out angles because I did record a video a while ago, and that was going to be my first video, and the angle was wonderful, but the camera was more in my way. In this angle, the camera wasn't as much in my way. But I think it works. I'm just gonna have to move it closer because I do work pulling the nails much closer to me. So yeah, I apologize about that, but we will have it fixed by the next video, so don't worry. Okay, moving on to the buffing process. That is the brand of the drill I'm going to be using today. I'm using a medium sanding bit for my nail drill. And I'm just gonna go ahead and buff the surface of my nails there. I know a lot of press-on nail makers or artists use a regular nail file. Well, some do. The ones that I've seen use a regular nail file to buff the shine off. But me, I have been using electric nail files since the beginning of my press-on nail making career, which was since I was like 17, 18, and I'm 19 now. So I've been doing that for quite a while, and it makes the process a heck of a lot faster, and it's just way easier, and I think that it buffs them way better personally than, you know, doing it by hand or whatever. You really get the shine off there. So yeah, that's just why I use an electric nail file. Also, if some are wondering why do we buff the top of the nails, we buff the top of the nails to take the shine off, just as you would doing natural nails. And this is just so that the product can stick to the nail better. So yeah, that's why we buff the top of the nails. Alright, moving on to the base coating process. Now I'm using iGel Beauty's base coat, just a personal favorite. I've used OPI's base coat and it's okay, but not the best to me. And I've used some other brands of base coat, but this one for gel, personally, I love it and it works great. Also, I love their top coat, iGel Beauty's top coat, the No Cleanse one preferably. Works wonderful as well, but I'm just gonna go ahead and apply my base coat, and this is going to be a full gel based set. I do acrylic sets as well, but today we're going to be doing a full gel based set. So I apply the base coat so that everything can seal on to the nail and it doesn't lift or whatever, and it just helps with overall quality. So yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and apply that to all of my nails, and then I'm going to let them cure in my iGel Beauty gel machine for 30 seconds, 2 times. Okay, so let's go ahead and put on our builder gel. So I'm going to be using iGel Beauty's builder gel in a bottle in color natural. I absolutely love this builder gel. I have every color in their builder gel. The only color that I didn't like was the sheer nude that they made, but other than that, I love all of their builder gel in a bottle colors. They're so pigmented and they just work really good, and the quality once it cures does great for my press-ons. I love it. You can't tell the difference from them being acrylic or gel, really, because builder gel is acrylic. It's just, well, iGel Beauty's builder gel in a bottle is vegan. I don't know if all builder gel is, but I know that theirs is, and it works great. But yeah, so I usually start by applying the builder gel in the center of the nail and kind of working my way up to the cuticle of the press on, and then I go down to the sides, mostly because sometimes if you don't even it out well, you'll have like little clumps on the sides of the nail, so it'll be like a big blob when it cures, and you don't want that. So to even it out, that's the way that I do it. I start off in the middle, work my way up to the cuticle, and then go down on the side so that it's all even and thinned out in the right places. And I did 3 coats of this because I didn't want it to be sheer, like see-through. So 3 coats usually get the job done for me. You could do 2, but I do 3. So yeah, and I'm going to show you guys what it looks like from the second coat, from the first, second, and third coat. So you can really see how well that their builder gel works. I've said builder gel a lot. It's kind of a tongue twister, but anyways. So yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and do that. And I use their iGel Beauty, I believe it's LED and UV gel machine, and they have a builder gel setting on there. So I think you usually cure builder gel for like 60-90 seconds, but I really don't know because they have that setting on the machine and that's all that I use. So yeah, you read the bottle if you don't have a builder gel setting on your gel machine to see how long to actually cure it. But yeah, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do that for both nails, and I'll be back when it's done. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and move on to the second coat for our builder gel base. Also, I kind of wanted to explain a little bit what I meant in the last clip about like how acrylic and builder gel are kind of the same to me. If you read iGel Beauty's builder gel, I'm going off theirs, not off other brands, because I have not had experience with other builder gel brands. But for iGel Beauty's specifically, theirs says it's pretty much like acrylic. It hardens just like acrylic. It lasts just as long as acrylic. The benefits is there is no smell from like the monomer and all of that, of course, because gel does not have a smell, of course, a very harsh smell like acrylic does. So if you're allergic to acrylic, or if you just are sensitive to acrylic, I think that this is the best bet to go. It will last up to 2 weeks, just like acrylic would. So yeah, no difference to me really, other than, of course, you don't get the wide variety of color options, but other than that, it's all the same to me. So right now I'm just wiping off the sticky layer from the builder gel. We did all 3 coats, and I skipped the ring finger because I wanted that one to stay sticky because of the design that I'm going to be doing on that one, so I didn't want to wipe it completely clean. But yeah, so I wiped the other ones clean and I took the sticky layer off to be able to work on those. Okay, let's get into the decorating process. So we are going to be decorating the ring finger first, and I'm using my stone gel glue. The sticky layer that I left wasn't sticky enough, so I just applied a very, very small amount of my jailstone glue on all over the nail. And then I'm just going to go ahead and take my gold nail foil and just place it all over. In the video, you will see me placing it, kind of trying to do like an ombre effect. But later on, I was going to trust the process, but then I was looking at it and I was like, I can't trust this process. So I ended up putting it all over, but you will see me applying it like I'm doing it as an ombre effect because I was trusting the process, but later on I failed on that. But it still came out good regardless, which you will see later on. But yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and apply this all over the nail. Also, again, sorry about it being out of frame while I was recording. I could have sworn I was just in frame the whole time, but now that I know, I will move my camera and place it differently. But for now, you get the gist. I'm just applying the gold nail foil, nothing special, but yeah. Okay, now let's get to the capsulation process. Yeah, I don't know if I said that right, but either way, we're going to be capsulating. So I'm using iGel Beauty's clear builder gel in a bottle to capsulate the gold onto the nail. Like I said, this stuff is wonderful. I love that it's in a bottle because you can apply it like gel polish or nail polish and it works so good. You just have to know not to use a whole lot and know how much to use and how to use it, whatever, but it works great nonetheless. I only did one coat of this. I mean the clear builder gel is very, very thick, but you can see how well it encapsulated the gold in right there. So yeah, again, love it. Moving on to the French tip process. I'm going to be French tipping the rest of these nails with this emerald green color. I forgot the name of that polish, but I did show it in frame there, so hopefully y'all saw it. But yeah, so I'm just gonna apply a few drops of this to my little tray over there, and then I'm going to be using my iGel Beauty's design tool brush, the long end of the brush, to do the French tip. And again, out of frame. It's not completely out of frame, but it's not where I would have liked it to be. But try to stay with me. So I placed a line in the middle tip of the nail. Then I took my brush and I went bringing the sides, meeting the line at the middle. And yeah, that's kind of how I make my French tips. And then I just take my polish and from the bottle, and then I just fill it in like that. I did kind of mess up a little bit, just slightly, when I went to go fill it in. But I went back and I fixed it. But this is the easiest way. I do a little bit of a different technique when I do longer nails. But when I do short nails, I do this technique. I think it just gives me a better French tip overall. But yeah, hopefully you can kind of see what I'm doing. It's not completely out of frame, but you have to like look down, and it's not what I was quite going for, but it will be fixed. But yeah, so right now, as you see, I'm just filling it in, and then you'll kind of see where I messed up a little bit, but off camera, I went back and I fixed it, and it was no biggie at all. Also, I really want you guys to see, and I'm going to show you how well that this French tip came out. Like, it came out just almost perfect. Like, the lines were just so nice to look at. Like, I literally just stared at them. This was the thumb there after I went back and I fixed it. Just look at the lines, y'all. Like, look at that. Look at it. And it didn't even take me hours to do this French tip. Like, it just, it came out so well. But anyways, so now that I finished that, I'm going to go ahead and go on with my iGel Beauty No Cleanse Top Coat. And no, this is not sponsored. I just really love iGel Beauty's products. But iGel Beauty, if y'all want to sponsor me, you know, get at me, you know, DM me on Instagram or message me on Facebook, whatever. Yeah, hit me up because I love y'all's stuff and I definitely use a lot of y'all's products. But anyways, moving on. So I'm going to be applying this to all of my nails. Like I said, this is no cleanse, so you will not have to wipe off. There will be no sticky layer left over after you cure it for 60 seconds, which I do. It's done. You don't have to worry about it. And they're all finished and they leave this wonderful shine. Like, I just love Ideal Beauty's top coat. I remember I posted this, not this set, but a set in my Facebook group chat, and everyone was asking me about the top coat, like, because the finish is absolutely wonderful. But yeah, so as you can see, I kept going over this one because I like my top coat to be smooth, and sometimes I get bubbles when applying it, so I just was going in and smoothing out the bubbles. But then I get a little bit too into it because there's times I can be a bit of a perfectionist and I will keep going over it. But yeah, so sorry. Anyways, this is the finished product, y'all. Look how beautiful. My client loved them. She's seen this before I put up the video. But anyways, like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I hope you guys enjoyed. Also, if you guys would like to order a press-on set from me, DM me on Instagram at Breeze Press-On, B-R-I-E-S, Press-On on Instagram, and I usually get back with fast responses. But I hope you guys enjoyed. Bye!